news of great joy for all the people. To you, born this day in the city of David, a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with an angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and peace on men of goodwill among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Congregation may be seated. So much, Sue. So it's been a long day. I don't know if any of you have had a long checklist of things you've needed to check off in order to get to Christmas Eve to welcome in families and things of that nature. Yesterday was cruising along quite well for me, and then I chipped my tooth. I called the dentist immediately, thinking, "Oh, can I get in? Maybe not. Maybe before Christmas. Maybe after." They said, "How about 7 a.m. this morning?" I said, "Sure, I'll be there." But before I went there, I got some candy canes for our children's message, and I stopped at Walmart real quick before 7 a.m. At Walmart, I don't know if you know, they don't have checkers that are on in their turnstile areas. You have to go through the checkout yourself and the scanning area that you can do it yourself. And there was a gentleman who was not having a good morning. You could tell he had been shopping. He had a few items, and he needed someone to help him check out. I think it was some videos that he was getting, or maybe it was a game. And he was not in the best mood. And he couldn't believe that on Christmas Eve, they didn't have a number of people checking them out. And I was thinking to myself, I can't believe you're waiting till the morning of Christmas Eve to be buying gifts for those people that are important to you. It was kind of oxymoronic thinking that we expect on a holiday there would be more checkers and people working to serve us, but forgetting that on Christmas Eve, isn't it about Jesus being born tomorrow? We're in a culture and a world that has just really got the messages all mixed up of why Christmas is important. I usually don't listen to Christmas music till after Thanksgiving. It's kind of my rule. But for some reason, I started listening to Christmas music earlier this year. It was on the radio, and so I started listening. And there, you know, I'm always looking forward to a Christmas song I haven't heard before. And I heard one, and I'm like, "Ooh, I hope this is good." And it actually was really good. What Christmas means. Not what Christmas means to me, that's a Stevie Wonder one that's been around forever. What Christmas Means by Kem, K-E-M, that's his stage name, sings this song. I think it's been out for about 7 years. But it talks about, I hope that you will understand what Christmas is all about as you go through the many busy things that we have going on in our lives and the things that we make ourselves do. But in this song, it talks about how Jesus is, so to speak, the way for us. How God's love sets us free. How God's love is there for you and for me and for this world to discover. I hope you will find what Christmas means. No matter what you're doing, but what you do will be for the right reasons. We get a little bent out of shape thinking this world is to serve us all the time and we're to have convenience in everything that we do. But if you know, like myself, not everything is convenience. Not everything is set up so that I can be comforted in this world. gives us Jesus this night so that he might come and live for you and for me to share with this world all of who God is before he will eventually die by being crucified on the cross. Taking our sin and taking death to that cross so that when he is risen from the dead 3 days later, he has victory over sin and death and the ways of this world. We seem to think that everything and everyone should be serving us. And we forget the meaning and reason of Christmas. I was reading about some older carols that we sing around this time of the year. And I know we've got those signs that you see out on the yard, put Christ in Christmas, or Jesus is the reason for the season, and some of those quotes that we have out there. But I was reading one of the old carols in the 1800s that was trying to combat the busyness of the world. 120 years ago, more than that, 200 years ago. It's been a part of this world. And we can get sucked into the way of this world, or we can follow something that's more important, and that gives us meaning. This babe that is born gives us life, gives us hope, gives us joy, gives us more than we can ever imagine and many things that we will never ever know or use in our lives. Jesus is there for you and for me and for people we will see as we gather for Christmas and family members and Christmas parties that we have for work or that we've done at school or that we might do at other places. I'm reminded as I came back from continuing ed just before Thanksgiving, I traveled to Leading Well Learning Conference. This is the third year of three that I could attend. I received a grant, and it's been a very fulfilling and rewarding conference to go to. So I'm a leader in a congregation, and as pastors, we are called to help others to lead with us and to build up other leaders alongside. How do we do that in our day? One of the questions we were asked about doing that is, what is most important or central to the gospel for you? That was a question I've heard before, but it just resounded to me, and it started to impact me like, important about this baby tonight? What is really important about Jesus in our lives? What is the good news for you? So I'm going to warm you up a little bit. I want you to look to the person to your right and say, Merry Christmas. I didn't say any kissing. I just said, say Merry Christmas. And now to the person to your left, say, I'm glad you're here tonight. Busy as families or as people as we gather together, we don't say that, right? We just show up and like, here we are, we've got all the gifts, we've got all the food, where do we put our luggage? We forget to say that we're glad you're here and Merry Christmas. It's an opportunity for us to do that. But tonight, you know, when we come together and worship, we expect that God will be present, that God will somehow come to life. That is an expectation in Lutheran worship, that God will show up in our worship. So I ask you tonight, what is for you the good news? What is important to you about Jesus tonight as you gather as family and friends for Christmas and maybe reunite with others at places where you have drinks and things like that? What is the good news for you? I want you to take a moment to think about that. Yeah, see, he's doing it already. What is the good news to you in tonight? Now you can share with someone that comes from our gospel? Really, I want you to talk. That was a big risk, wasn't it? Now I'm really going to risk even more. What was something that you or someone else said that is the good news to you or someone around you? Jesus is... What was that?
Born.
Jesus is born. Anything else?
Love.
Ooh, Jesus is love. Thank you.
God really loves
us. Really, really. We got to put the really in front of the love. I love that. Thank you. Jesus sets us free. Jesus is our hope. Yes, you have one back there. I'm not going to hear you way up here. Ooh, Jesus is creator. He created us. That is the good news, and that is what's important. Absolutely. Jesus is here for us, and as I shared with the children, we are never alone. Jesus goes with us wherever we are. So no matter what we face, no matter what we're going through, no matter if this time of the year is not the best season of the year for you, Jesus is with you and will walk with you and will care for you no matter what you face. I know that not everybody is doing well right now. I know that some people are struggling right now. I know that in this world there are some people that are not free. In fact, I was just talking with my dentist who was ready to go to Haiti to do a mission there to work on teeth. But in Haiti right now, it's not safe enough to go. So they can't help people who need some of the simplest dental care. And they will suffer for that because people in Haiti cannot get along. We live in a world that is worried about themselves. Right? What is the one thing we like to talk about most? Ourselves. That is proven for us. But Jesus reminds us that it's about this one who comes. And tonight, how can we do that when we give gifts, when we offer a prayer around our tables, when we see our loved ones and it's been a long time, or we have relationships that are maybe kind of rocky? Can we overcome that because of the love of Jesus? Can we overcome that and share that with one another? Can we really find what the meaning of Christmas is? Whatever that may be for you tonight. May Jesus enter into your homes, into your lives, into this Christmas time, no matter what's going on, so that you might know he came for you and for everyone around you, so that we might have life and have it abundantly. It's the greatest gift that God gives us that we can take home with us tonight and share with the world so freely. And the world can't take that away because God is much bigger, much stronger than what this world has to offer and tells us we should do. Share our sermon song, Angels We Have Heard On.